So again, welcome sa online lectures of Calculus 1 or Differential Calculus. So for today, we'll be discussing implicit differentiation. So let's define this first. Implicit differentiation. It follows the usual differentiation for x and y, except that it follows y prime upon differentiating a variable y. So to further illustrate this definition, let's solve first the following set of examples. So apply muna natin dito sa mga examples na meron tayo. So in our example, we'll be finding the derivative of y with respect to x. And as we go on, doon natin ipapakita ano ba yung pinakaiba ni implicit and ni explicit differentiation. So, we'll be solving the following problems. Okay? So, for problem number 1. For the first problem, number 1. So, we have x cubed plus y is equal to 10. So, balikan muna natin si explicit, yung ginagawa natin from the very beginning up to the last topic that we discussed. Ano? So, lahat ng mga derivatives, lahat ng yon ay explicit differentiation, of which we are noting that yung ating y should be written as a function of x. So, dapat siya ay y is equal to function of x. So, since ang example natin is nakasulat in the form of x cubed plus y is equal to 10, kailangan ma-rewrite muna natin to in the form of y as a function of x. So, yung y natin nasa left side, whereas yung function of x natin nasa right side. So, simplify muna natin to or transposing. So, we will have y is equal to 10 minus x cubed. Para maisulat natin to in the form of y as a function of x. And from here, makukuha na natin si first derivative or si y prime. So when we get the first derivative of this function, so 0, then negative, bababa yung 3, and this will be x squared. So as simple as this one. So yan yung ating value ni first derivative using explicit differentiation. So, simply writing the function in the form of y as a function of x. So, if we want to solve this one implicitly, so yung ginagawa natin dati, explicit. So, yung gagawin natin ngayon is implicit differentiation, of which magdi-differentiate tayo ng y mismo. Okay? So, kuhanin natin yung given. So, based on our given, we have x cubed plus y is equal to 10. So, we are tasked to find the derivative of y with respect to x. So, gawin natin, let's take the derivative of both sides with respect to x. Kunin lang natin si derivative with respect to x. So, following the rules in differentiation, didistribute lang natin yan. So, magiging derivative of x cubed with respect to x plus, so pakita lang natin ha, derivative of y with respect to x and is equal to derivative of 10 with respect to x. So, i-apply natin yung formula for differentiation since this one is with respect to x. Any other variable na hindi x will be treated as constant. So, in this case, magiging siyang 3x cubed. Then plus, so we have the derivative of y with respect to x. So, this can be written as dy over dx. Or, pwede natin siyang isulat as y prime. The derivative of y with respect to x is simply y prime. Is equal to derivative of constant. We all know that that is 0. So, we have this equation. So, isulat lang natin in this form. So, that is equal to, this should be x squared. So, y prime, transpose natin, is 3, negative 3 x square. So, parehas lang sila. Okay? So, pinakita lang sa atin, pag nag-derivative tayo ng y with respect to x, the result will be y prime. Then, pwede natin siyang i-arrange, depende kung ano yung pinapahanap. Since we are tasked to find the value of y prime, kailangan siya yung nasa left side of the equation. So, as simple as that. Let's try problem number 2. So, for the second problem, we have x square plus y square is equal to 10. So, let's solve this. So, in this equation, so, isolve muna natin explicitly. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, kailangan ma-write muna natin siya in the form of y as a function of x. So, to do so, transpose lang natin. This will be y square is equal to 10 minus x square. And solving for y, that is simply square root of 10 minus x square. Now, we have the given in the form of y as a function of x. So, para lang mas madali nating ma-differentiate, pwede naman natin itong isulat in this form. Y is equal to 10 minus x square raised to positive 1/2. Then, let's differentiate. Taking the derivative with respect to x, this will be y prime. Then, following the formula for the general power formula, so this will be 1/2. And this is 10 minus x square. Then, 1/2 minus 1, that is negative 1/2. Multiplied by derivative ng loob. So, this is 10. Derivative, that is 0. So, negative, bababa yung 2. We have here 2x, of which we can cancel out 2 here. Therefore, our y prime is simply negative x in the numerator divided by 10 minus x square raised to positive 1/2. Positive na kasi nilagay natin sa baba. Susulat lang natin in radical form, y prime is equal to negative x divided by square root of 10 minus x square. So, this will be our answer. So, you can see, sinolve natin siya explicitly. Ni-write muna natin yung function as a function, y as a function of x. So, let's solve this one implicitly. So, derecho. So, we have here x squared plus y square is equal to 10. So, solving this one implicitly. So, let's take the derivative of both sides with respect to x. So, taking the derivative with respect to x, so, derecho na natin, derivative of x square, so, bababa yung 2, then copy yung x, power formula, then raised to 1, multiplied by derivative of x with respect to x, that is 1. Then plus, bababa yung 2, may matitirang 1, 2 minus 1, multiplied by derivative ng loob. So, derivative of y with respect to x, that is simply y prime is equal to, so ito ay raised to 1, ito ay y prime. So, derivative of 10, that is simply 0. So, simplifying this, 2x raised to 1 times 1 is 2x plus 2y raised to 1, so that is 2y times y prime is equal to 0. Actually, from this equation, pwede tayong dumiretso dito kapag sanay na. So, pag kinuha natin yung derivative of this one with respect to x, bababa yung 2, may iwan yung x times derivative of x is 1. In this case, bababa yung 2, copy yung 1, minus 1, then derivative ng loob, so derivative ng y, that is simply y prime. So, the derivative of y squared is 2y, y prime. So, following the general power formula. So, bababa yung n, copy yung base, then n minus 1 sa exponent, multiplied by derivative ng loob. In this case, di ba ang loob natin is y. Kaya pag dinerivative natin si y with respect to x, we will arrive with y prime. Okay? So, in this case, since naka-equate siya sa 0, we can cancel out 2. So, we have x plus y, y prime is equal to 0. And isolating y prime, iwalay lang natin. So, tatranspose natin si negative x divided by y. So, y x plus y y prime is equal to 0. Transpose natin yung x naging y, y prime is equal to negative x. Para maging y prime line, divide natin ang y. So, ito yung magiging equivalent niya. Kasi dapat, yung y prime natin nasa left side of the equation. Okay? So, in this case, what is the value of y? So, we all know that x squared plus y squared is equal to 10. And from here, we can obtain the value of y. That is simply square root of 10 minus x squared. So, diba? Y squared is equal to 10 transpose minus x squared. Para maging y, let's take the square root. Therefore, y is simply square root of 10 minus x squared. So, this y, pwede nating i-substitute sa y dito. So, making the value or the equation, y prime is equal to negative x divided by square root of 10 minus x squared. And as you can see, they are of the same value. So, parehas yung equation na ating nakuha. So, with that, this answer can also be acceptable. Okay? So, acceptable ito. Negative x over y. So, kaya ko lang dinarecho dito to illustrate that parehas lang yung makukuha nating sagot. Whether you do explicit differentiation, making the function y as a function of x, or you can do implicit. Of which, pag nag-derivative ka ng y, may kasunod lagi na y prime. Okay? So, like this one. So, di ba, nag-derivative tayo ng y dito. Ang derivative natin si y square, yung normal natin gagawin is magigilang siyang 2y. But since nag-derivative tayo ng y, may karugtong lagi na y prime. So, yan yung parang mabilis na technique para madali mong maalala si implicit. Pag nag-derivative tayo ng y, may kasunod lagi siya na y prime. Or, you can apply the basic differentiation formulas. So, parehas lang din naman yung lalabas. Okay? So, let's proceed to other examples. Tignan natin yung iba pang examples. So, for example number 3. So, dun sa ating number 3, we have x square plus y square is equal to 2xy. Okay? In this case, kahit anong gawin natin, hindi na natin ito may isulat in the form of y as a function of x. Kasi hindi natin may ihiwala yung y squared at saka 2xy. Laging may matitira tayong variable na y. Of which, yun yung madaling palatandaan kung kailan ka gagamit ng implicit differentiation. So, gagamit tayo ng implicit differentiation pag hindi na natin ma-isolate yung y with the function of x. Or simply speaking, pag hindi natin ma-isulat yung ating form in the form of y as a function of x. So, yun. Yung explicit, yung ginagawa natin dati, pwede lang yung gamitin when our equation is in the form of y as a function of x. So, pag hindi na, we'll do implicit differentiation. So, let's do this. So, gamit lang tayo ng implicit differentiation. So, let's take the derivative of both sides with respect to x. So, both sides na yan. So, pag both sides natin, so derivative of this one with respect to x, so that is simply 2x. Then plus, derivative of y squared with respect to x, so bababa yung 2, copy si y. Multiplied by derivative ng loob, so derivative of y, that is y prime. So, yun. So, 2y times y prime is equal to 2. So, obviously, this is product rule. So, we'll be applying copy, take the derivative, plus copy, take the derivative. So, in this case, copy muna natin si x. So, copy yung x. Then, take the derivative of y. What is the derivative of y with respect to x? That is dy over dx, or dy dx, and that is simply y prime. So, yung derivative of y with respect to x is simply y prime. Plus, copy naman natin si y, and the derivative of x is simply 1. Inilabas ko na yung 2 kasi constant naman siya. Okay, so let's review this. So, the derivative of 2xy, labas ko lang yung 2. So, xy is a product. So, let's apply product rule. So, copy si x, derivative of y, is y prime, plus Kcy derivative of x with respect to x is 1. So, this will be the equation. So, again, pwede natin i-cancel yung mga 2 kasi common naman sila sa buong equation natin. So, rewrite lang natin. We have here x plus y, y prime is equal to x, y prime plus y. So, pagsamahin lang natin yung may y prime. So, pag pinagsama natin, iwan natin ito dito. So, magiging y, y prime transpose. So, minus x, y prime is equal to, iwan yung y, transpose yung x. So, that is y minus x. So, iniwan ko dito si y, y prime. Tinranspose ko lang si x minus y prime sa kabila. So, naging negative. Is equal to, naiwan yung y minus x. Kasi tinranspose natin to sa right side of the equation. So, factoring out y prime, kasi yun yung kailangan natin, isolate lang natin si y prime. So, we have here y minus x. And that is equal to y minus x. And with that, common ito, pwede natin makancel out. So, with that, we can solve for the value of y prime, yung y prime natin is simply 1. Okay, huwag mamimisinterpret na pag nakancel, magiging 0. Mali yun. So, pag nakancel to, magiging siyang 1. Kasi magiging y minus x divided by, pag nilagay mo ito sa ilalim, y minus x. And that is simply 1. Okay? So, pwede natin yung gawin using implicit differentiation. Okay? So, let's have another solution. Total may space naman dito. So, for the second solution, so, di ba yung given natin is x squared plus y squared is equal to 2xy. So, pwede natin itong i-transpose. Gawin natin x squared plus y squared minus 2xy is equal to 0. So, para lang mas malinaw, pwede ko itong ilagay in this form. X squared minus 2xy plus y squared is equal to 0. And when we apply factoring here, notice that this is a perfect square trinomial. So, perfect square siya ni x minus y being square. So, to check, square the first term, x square. Multiply the product of first and second 2 times 2. So, that is negative xy times 2. That is negative 2xy. Squaring the last term, that is y square. So, pag finactor out natin yung ating given, magpo-form tayo ng x minus y being square. Or simply, the square of binomial. Or, itong factor na to, itinatawag natin perfect square trinomial. So, in this case, so, pwede nating makuha yung value ng, pwede natin itong isimplify. So, taking the square root of both sides. So, square root of x minus y being square, may tirang x minus y. Square root of 0, obviously, 0 pa din. Then, transpose lang natin. In this case, we will form y is equal to x. And we form y as a function of x. And with that, pag dinerivative natin to, si y magiging y prime. Pag dinerivative natin si x, that will be 1. And notice, the same yung magiging sagot. Okay, so let's continue solving the next problems. Yeah. So let's have number 4 na tayo. Number 4. So x cubed multiplied by cosine of y is equal to 10. So in this case, hindi na natin basta ma-isolate yung y kasi nasa loob siya nung cosine. Pwede naman, so ang gagawin lang natin, cosine y is equal to 10 over x cubed, then take the inverse cosine or the arc cosine of y. So of which, magka-form tayo ng y is equal to arc cosine of 10 over x cube. So, pwede pa rin explicit. Ano? Kasi nag-form tayo ng y as a function of x. So, babalik lang tayo sa derivative ng inverse trigonometric function. So, still solvable siya. But since marunong na naman tayo ng implicit, we'll be applying implicit differentiation here. So, instead, let's take the derivative of this equation with respect to x. So, pag ginawa natin ang derivative, again, derivative to ng product. So, copy mo na si x cube. Then, take the derivative of cosine y. We all know that the derivative of cosine magiging siyang negative sine of y. Diba? Derivative ng cosine is negative sine. Then, ang kasunod ay derivative ng loob or derivative ng angle. So, derivative of y, that is simply y prime. So, yun yung sinasabi natin kanina. Pag nag-derivative ka ng y, may kasunod lagi na y prime. Take note that this y prime ay hindi na angle ng sine. Okay? So, still yung angle niya ay y lamang. So, yung y prime nakamultiply sa buong negative sine y. So, that is copy. Take the derivative. So, derivative of cosine y is negative sine y multiplied by the derivative of y with respect to x, which is y prime. Then plus, copy naman natin si cosine y. Then take the derivative of x cube with respect to x. So, that is 3x square. Then, is equal to 0. Kasi derivative of 10 with respect to x is 0. So, copy, take the derivative, plus, copy, then take the derivative. So, 3x square. So, isulat lang natin ng maayos. Unahin ko lang to. So, it is 3x square cosine of y minus, so we have x cube y prime multiplied by sine y is equal to 0. So, that is 3x squared cosine y minus x cube y prime multiplied by sine y. Okay, yung y natin dito ay angle doon sa loob ng sine. Okay? So, i-form lang natin si y prime. I-isolate lang natin si y prime. So, let's transpose this. So, magiging itong x cube multiplied by y prime multiplied by sine of y. So, tanarangspose ko na. That is equal to 3x squared multiplied by cosine of y. So, to solve for y prime, so, magiging yung 3x squared cosine of y, divide lang natin ng x cube sine of y. So, simplifying this, y prime natin is simply 3. Then, x squared over x cube. So, syempre, nasa ilalim yung ating x. Then, cosine over sine, we have it as cotangent of y. So, this will be our answer. So, y prime is equal to 3 cotangent y over x, or 3 over x multiplied by cotangent of y. So, that is for our number 4. So, let's solve number 5. So, for problem number 5, dito na lang. Okay? So, given y multiplied by ln of x plus x multiplied by ln of y is equal to 0. Okay. So, this is our given. So, solve lang natin. Again, implicit na tayo. So, let's take the derivative of this one with respect to x. So, this is derivative ng product. So, copy muna natin si y. Then, the derivative of ln of x with respect to x. So recall, yung derivative natin ng ln of u is equal to derivative of u over u. So in this case, the derivative of ln of x is the derivative of x with respect to x, which is 1, all over u. In this case, yung u natin ay x. So the derivative of ln of x with respect to x is 1 over x. Then plus, copy naman natin si ln of x. Then take the derivative of y with respect to x, that is y prime. So copy, take the derivative. Plus, copy, then take the derivative. Ang kabila naman. Plus, copy naman natin si x, the derivative of ln of y. So the derivative of ln of y with respect to x. So that is the derivative of u over u. So derivative ng u natin, derivative ng y with respect to x, that is y prime over u. In this case, yung u natin is y. Plus, copy naman natin si ln of y. Then, the derivative of x with respect to x is simply 1. And equate natin kay 0. The derivative of 0 is 0. So, ipatasin lang natin. So, this will be y over x plus y prime ln of x plus x y prime over y plus ln of y is equal to 0. So, pagsamahin lang natin yung may mga y prime. So, yung may y prime dito, that is y prime ln of x then plus x y prime over y. Then, transpose natin yung wala. So, yung wala. So, we have negative ln of y then minus y over x. Okay? So, factor out lang natin dito yung y prime. So, yung y prime natin here is simply ln of x plus x over y. Then, this is negative. Labasan natin yung negative sign. That is negative ln of y plus y over x. Nilabas lang natin si negative sign. So, let's simplify this by taking the LCD. Kunin lang natin yung LCD or the least common denominator ng ating equation. So, in this case, y prime. So, yung LCD natin, obviously, will be y. So, y, yan ditong y ln of x plus x is equal to negative. Then, take the LCD, which is x. So, magigitong x ln of y. Okay? So, magiging siyang x ln of y over x and plus y dun sa ating numerator. Okay? So, pag kinuha natin si y prime, so, solving for y prime, magiging siyang negative x ln of y plus y over x. Then, pwede natin gamitan ng cross multiplication or itong buong to, i-divide natin dito. Then, pag dinivide natin, we are going to take the reciprocal of the denominator, then proceed to multiplication. So, ito pumunta sa baba, then reciprocal or simply cross multiply. So, in this case, I will apply cross multiplication. So, yung y dito, punta sa taas. So, magiging siyang y all over. Ito yung part na to, magiging denominator, this part. Okay? So, magiging y, pag cross multiply, all over y ln of x plus x. Okay? So, therefore, we can solve for y prime. So, solving for y prime. So, that is negative. Hanayin ko lang yung y. Multiply natin ng x. Ln of y plus y. All over. So, hanayin ko lang yung x. Multiply by y. Ln of x plus x. So, this will be our answer. Okay, so let's proceed with problem number 6. Okay, sayang pa. So let's have... Okay, so let's have problem number 6. So for problem number 6, we have y square is equal to ln of x squared plus y squared. So let's solve this again implicit. So let's take the derivative with respect to x. So, derivative of y squared with respect to x. So, that is 2, combine 2. Then, y raised to 1, derivative of y, that is y prime. So, derivative ng y squared with respect to x is simply 2y, y prime. Is equal to ln. Derivative ng ln of x squared. So, the derivative of ln u is derivative of u over u. So, derivative muna natin yung taas. So, the derivative of u, that is 2. Derivative of x squared, that is 2x times 1. Plus, bababa yung 2, y, again, y prime. The derivative of y squared over u. So, u natin ay x squared plus y squared. Okay? So, sinunod lang natin yung formula in getting the derivative of ln of u. That is derivative of u over u. So, this is u, x squared plus y squared. So, the derivative is 2x plus 2y, y prime over u, which is x squared plus y squared. So, simplify lang natin. This is 2y, y prime. Nabas ko lang yung 2. Magiging x plus y, y prime. And over x squared plus y squared. So, we can cancel out 2 here. So, magiging y, y prime is equal to x plus y, y prime all over x squared plus y squared. So, cross multiplying. So, magiging y, y prime multiplied by x squared plus y squared is equal to x plus y, y prime. So, distribute muna natin. So, we will have here x squared times y prime plus y squared y squared times y, so that is y cube times y prime. Okay, to distribute x squared y, y prime plus y cube y prime is equal to x plus y, y prime. So, pagsamahin lang natin yung my y prime. So, this will be x squared y, y prime plus y cube y prime minus y y prime is equal to x. So, yun lang natin doon yung x. So, let's isolate y prime here. So, yung y prime natin is equal to, and dito sa taas na x squared y plus y cube. Sorry, naka-multiply ito. So, we have y prime. Pag nalabas natin yung y prime, so, may y prime times x squared y plus y cube minus y is equal to x. So, that is x squared y prime plus y cube y prime minus y prime is equal to x. So, solving for y prime, okay, that is, so, is x over x squared y plus y cube minus y. So this will be our answer. Okay, so let's proceed with the last example. So this last example, since we are finding the derivative with respect to x, so this last example, number 7, so given na ito dun sa huli natin diniscuss in getting the derivative of exponential function. So of which, sinolve natin to using explicit differentiation. So, by this time, solve natin implicitly. So, hindi ko na ipapakita yung unang solution. Kasi yun ay nasa video natin ng derivative of exponential functions. So, we'll be having another solution for this example. So, for problem number 7, so we have y is equal to x e raised to x. So, take note that we do not have the formula for this kind of function. Okay? So, hindi natin ito pwedeng i-derivative ng derecho. Because, ang meron tayo is the derivative of function of x raised to n or u raised to n. Where n is any constant value. So, in this case, e raised to x is not a constant value. So, hindi natin pwedeng i-apply yung formula for the power formula. Yung ating power formula, hindi natin siya pwedeng i-apply. So, instead, i-manipulate natin. Okay? So, diba, given tayo ng y is equal to x e raised to x. So, kailangan madala natin to sa form na meron tayong formula. So, we have the derivative of all function except this one. So, to solve this, so kagaya ng ginawa natin sa solution using exponential function, let's take first the logarithm of both sides. So, I'll be using the Napierian or the natural logarithm, ln. So, taking ln of both sides, this will be ln of y is equal to ln of x e raised to x. So, this will be ln of y. So, applying properties of logarithm. So, this first part, the same dun sa ginawa natin dati. So, bababa lang si e raised to x. Multiplied siya ng ln of x. Okay? So, yan yung ating magiging form. Then, let's apply implicit differentiation. So, from this one, meron na naman tayong derivative ng logarithmic at saka exponential. So, pwede na natin itong i-derivative both sides. Implicit. So, derivative natin with respect to x. So, again, the derivative of ln is derivative of u over u. So, u natin is y. So, the derivative of y with respect to x is y prime over u. So, in this case, that is simply y is equal to, this is derivative ng product. So, copy natin si e raised to x multiplied by derivative of ln of x. So, derivative of x is 1 over u, which is x. So, that is 1 over x. So, copy, take the derivative. Plus, copy natin si ln of x and the derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x times derivative of x is simply 1. So, we can write it like y prime over y is equal to So, pwede natin ilabas yung e raised to x, common monomial factor. So, that is e raised to x, and we have here 1 over x plus ln of x. So, nilabas ko lang or finactor out ko lang si e raised to x. Then, cross multiplying, since ang hinahanap sa atin is y prime, so we have y e raised to x multiplied by 1 over x plus ln of x. So, what is the value of y? We all know that y here is x e raised to x. So, we can have it as y prime. So, yung y palitan natin ang x e raised to x multiplied by e raised to x multiplied by 1 over x plus ln of x. And this will be our answer. Okay? So, kung na-recall nyo yung naging solution natin sa last time using derivative of exponential function, mas mahaba yung naging process natin. Unlike nung gumamit tayo ng implicit differentiation. Okay, so para lang may pakita na tama yung ating sagot, so here is the solution na meron tayo last time using logarithmic function. Medyo naging scratch na lang yung papel. So, yan. Ito yung naging solution natin last time. So, explain ko na lang ng mabilis. So, ang ginawa natin, kagaya nung solution natin kanina, we'll get the ln or the natural logarithm of both sides. So, naging ln of y is equal to ln of x e raised to x. So, bumaba yung e raised to x. So, we have ln of y is equal to e raised to x ln of x. And, para maging y na lang ulit yung ating form. So, yung ating equation na ln of y is equal to e raised to x ln of x. Again, in-erase natin ng e, both sides. So, naging e raised to ln of y is equal to e raised to e raised to x times ln of x, of which e raised to ln, so sabi natin last time, property of the logarithm, pag nagparehas yung base ni logarithmic function at saka yung base ni exponent, that would be cancelled out. We all know that ln is logarithm to the base e. So, yung base ni logarithm in ln is e. So, parehas yung base dito is e, then yung base ng exponent natin is e. Therefore, e raised to ln will be cancelled out. Ang matitira lang sa atin is y. Then, meron ditong e raised to x times ln of x. And we let u is equal to yung equation, yung exponent, which is e raised to x times ln of x. So, when we apply derivative form, product rule of differentiation in this given, so derivative of u with respect to x, so copy, take the derivative, plus copy, then take the derivative, we will have this function. Derivative of u with respect to x is e raised to x over x plus e raised to x ln of x. So, gumamit tayo ng chain rule of differentiation. So, sa chain rule, we have y is equal to e raised to u. So, y prime is equal to e raised to u times du over dx. So, basically, ito yung formula natin. Pag kumukuha tayo ng derivative of e raised to u. So, that is e raised to u times du over dx. So, substituting e raised to u. So, yung u natin is e raised to x ln of x. Substitute lang. Times du dx, which is this one. Yung factor na ito. So, substitute lang natin. So, ito, tinaas ko lang yung e raised to x. So, ginawa natin e raised to ln of x, e raised to x multiplied by this factor. And again, e raised to ln is x e raised to x times this factor. So, common monomial factor, pag nilabas natin si e raised to x, ito yung magiging sagot. Which happens to be parehas or the same dun sa ating sagot kanina. Okay, so ito yung sagot natin using implicit differentiation. Mas maigsi, pero parehas lang. So basically, implicit differentiation, so kaya nga nang dinedefine natin dyan, it follows the usual differentiation for x and y. Parehas lang. Ang pinagkaiba lang niya, pag nag-derivative tayo ng y with respect to x, laging may kasunod na y prime. So kagaya nung sa mga solutions natin kanina, once na nag-derivative tayo ng y with respect to x, laging merong y prime. So, pwede tayong gumamit ng explicit differentiation provided na maiisulat natin yung ating function in the form of y as a function of x. Kung hindi, we'll be using implicit. So, kagaya ng solutions natin kanina, parehas lang yung magiging sagot natin. On most cases, mas mabilis ang implicit. Okay? Kasi hindi na natin kailangang gawing komplikado yung ating pagsusolve. Okay? So, that's it for implicit differentiation.